Good afternoon. This is the last Friday of October. In just a few days, we're going to jump into the month of November, and things are just going to start flying for us as we approach the end of the semester. We have a special event that we want to share information about with you. Before we do that, though, on next Monday, that would be November the 1st, our soccer team will be involved in a playoff game here at Swain County. It'll be up at the field at 7 o'clock. So please put that on your calendar. And then on Tuesday evening, here in the Performing Arts Center at 6 o'clock, our band will be performing on stage. And I don't think we've been able to perform indoors in probably 18 months. So I would encourage you to come and be part of that. And then on Thursday, November the 4th, East Elementary is going to be celebrating the 30th anniversary of the opening of that building. I don't think that people really understand in our community that when we talk about our newest buildings, we're talking about East and West Elementary. And the primary structures are 30 years old this year. This building is 35 or 40 years old. And people just don't understand that our facilities are in really great shape because we've really taken care of them well. So that event, the 30th anniversary, is going to be tied together with East Elementary Fall Festival, and it'll start at 5 and last until 7 p.m. So please put those things on your calendar. And also, we have something else that's on the calendar for the first time in quite a while. And that's a musical production that's going to be involving a number of people, including Bella and Elkie and our amazing director. So tell us about that, the dates and what's going to happen.
Okay. Hi, Swain County. We're so excited. We're back. That's basically the message. We are beyond excited to share. Musical theater, as you guys know, has just been at a halt from the top down, and we are just now getting to be back. We have a show that Musical Theater International, which is a place we buy a lot of shows from, gave to us as a fundraiser to get started again, because as some of you guys might know, when we lost Adam's family, we didn't have ticket sales that year, so we've just really had a hard time since then. So this is a fundraiser. Not only can you come help, but you're going to have a blast. We have so many musical numbers from shows that you probably grew up with or you love. We have special guests coming. We have the Mr. Jay Gilbert is going to be on the stage again. We are beyond excited about that. We have Rachel Yates is coming back. Emily Franklin, my husband Matt Hewitt is doing a song. We have the middle school group. There's a new performance class at the middle school, and all three of the grades, 6, 7, and 8, are going to be on this stage, and we are just beyond excited. And there's even more people. Oh, Caleb King is coming back too. So you might be wondering, how do I get to come see this magic on stage? I'm gonna tell you right now. The 13th is a Saturday and it's at 7 o'clock, and the box office here is gonna open at 6 o'clock, so you can buy tickets here, but we are also going to have a link where you can purchase tickets online. We still wanna be safe, and so that's also a way for you to guarantee a spot because we still have limited seating in here. So that should be up sometimes next week. We also have a show on Sunday the 14th, and that is at 3 o'clock. Box office will open at 2, and again, you can buy your tickets online for that. All I can say is these kids have worked so hard, and we are having the time of our life, truly, just singing and dancing again. It's just so much fun. So please come join the fun, celebrating all the arts in Swain County. What a rich heritage we have. Loving the arts here. It's one of the most beautiful things in the community, in my opinion. So come play, come see it, and we're excited.
And so what I heard was on November the 13th, starting at 7 o'clock, the show begins. Box office opens at 6. November the 14th, at 3 o'clock, the show begins. Box office opens at 2.
Yes.
And this is the first time we've been able to do something like this in quite a while. And that's why one of the reasons that it's important. Our arts programs all across the country have kind of been shut down for a while, particularly in public education. And they haven't been able to raise money for this. And so the company that is providing this is actually doing it free of charge. And not only is Swain County going to be doing that, but your mother's going to be producing this also in Florida on the same weekend. So all across America, You're going to be participating, and you can too. But I want to talk to some of the people who are involved in it. And so I've got Elke standing here with me, and Elke has some unique perspectives because you are a junior.
Yeah.
And you have not really been able to be on stage in this type of a production. So tell me, what's this like for you, and what are you doing in your work with this production?
This has been an incredible experience to be a part of. Obviously, he said I'm a junior, and I haven't gotten a chance to be on stage. Last year, I helped with the play Clue. I was a stage manager. But this is the first time we've been able to do a full musical production since the pandemic began. And because of that, it's just been inclusive to everyone. I myself, I'm helping stage manage, I'm helping choreograph, and I'm even singing in it. And it's just a wonderful chance for everyone to discover who they are in the world of theater.
And so, Elke, one of the additional beautiful parts of this is the fact that almost anybody can participate in it. As a matter of fact, my understanding is that we have an elementary student who's going to be singing a song in it, aside from the fact that we have community members, and also the middle school is going to be participating as well. And I think that it's worth noting that that really is kind of what the arts does for us. It gives everyone, regardless of your age or perhaps your gender or anything else, the opportunity to come together. Speaking of anyone, Bella is here with us, and Bella is also a junior and hasn't been able to participate in something like this. So Bella, tell us, what is this bringing into your life, and what exactly will you be doing as part of the program, which I believe is called
All Together Now.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so tell us about that.
Okay, so I'm actually the student director for this production. It's our first musical production in like a long time. And I'm just like seeing the side of producing. Like, I've been on stage most of the time. And so this is like really exciting opportunity that Miss Hewitt's given me. And I'm just like so happy that like I'm involved in this. And so some of the things I've been doing behind the scenes is I actually helped pick out the music mm-hmm. in it and cast people in the songs and the parts of it that we mm-hmm. are doing. And yeah, it's just, I'm super excited about it.
And so you are, Bella, are actually operating as a producer as
yes.
well. And the producer has some specific responsibilities.
Right.
What are your specific responsibilities for this production as a producer?
So I'm here to make sure like I'm structuring and organizing everything the way it's supposed to be. Like, I'm telling people, you know, this is the song we're about to do, or just making sure everything's where it needs to be, because I'm trying to make this, like, we're all trying to make this like a really great production, because it's going to really bring the community back together. And it's also showcasing that vocal ensemble is back and we're going to be better than ever.
And I'm excited to hear the vocal ensemble, you know, when it's operating just as the vocal ensemble. But let's kind of pull all these pieces back together, all right? November the 13th and 14th. The times are 7 on the 13th, 3 o'clock on the 14th. All together now. Lots and lots of people
yes.
participating in lots of different capacities.
Yes.
And we want for you to be part of it. So please put this on your calendar. If you have any questions, you can contact Miss Hewitt here at the high school, or you can contact some of us, and we will do everything we can to make sure that you can see our show. Please bring your children to this.
Yeah, this is really great.
Because these ladies were reminding me just a few minutes ago that we have third graders who have never seen a production like this. Never. And somehow we're going to try and help them do that too, I hope. All right. So until the next time we're together, thank you so much for supporting our arts programs,
yes.
our school system, and for being part of our family. Until the next time, God bless you. Have a great weekend. Go Maroon Devils.
Yes. Yes.